Hare Krishna Maharaj, in today's Srimad Bhagavatam has been read the prayers of the demigods, and one of the prayers the demigods said, you are the complete whole. So could you analyze this more?
You are the what whole?
Complete whole.
You are the complete whole.
Yeah.
哎，你直接说一遍中文。
就是在我们今天的三点佛教网堂课六点、九点、十二，就英文里面的八声向主祈祷说，您是完整的整体。我想请Guru再详细的讲一下怎么样去正确的理解。
Just before we begin, I just wanted to ask all the devotees that because this morning Shamsundari Mataji in Taiwan, she's undergoing another operation for her breast cancer. So we can also include her in the prayers which we did for Sandini's husband.
我们得到消息呢，台湾的Shamsundari Mataji，他的乳腺癌，
对，
今天要做一个手术，所以我们在祈祷的时候呢，也为他也做出祈祷。
So, thank you. So, Lord Krishna or the demigods are praying to the Supreme Lord, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Narayan, and they're describing him as the Supreme Whole.
但是人们在向至尊主拿拉亚呢，祈祷，称他为至高无上的完整的整体。
Well, that is also brought up in Ishopanishad, where the Lord is described as Purnam, perfect and complete.
至尊奥义书当中呢，也称至尊主是 Purnam, 他是完整的整体。
Is a complete whole.And it's inconceivable that he remains a complete whole, even though so many complete units emanate from him.
即便有这么多的单元从他那里流演出来，他依然保持是完整的整体。
Om Purnam Adapurnamidam Purnat Purnam Udachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. So this is the.Prayer in the Ishopanishad that the Lord is perfect and complete. And the example is given about how you may have a book, and if you take one page out of the book, then the book is no longer complete.
在至尊奥义书当中的这个祈祷文就有这个 Om Purnamada, 就这个称至尊主是完整的整体。我们有一个比喻，有一个例子。我们有一本书，倘若我们撕掉一页呢，这本书就不完整了。
Or you may have a car, and you take out some piece from the engine of the car. You take out one thing, and then the car is no longer complete.
或者是一辆轿车，倘若我们从轿车上取下一个零件，这轿车也不再完整。
But Lord Krishna, he is always perfect and complete, even though so many things come from him.He still remains complete.
但至尊主 Krishna, 他永远都是完美，既完美又完整的。即便有那么多的单元从他那里流演出来，他仍然是完美又完整。
We'd like to have a bank account like that.
我们希望我们那个银行的账号也账户也是既完美又完整。
Right? You go shopping and you spend and.Your bank account is always perfect and complete. Doesn't matter how much you spend.
我们拿着我们的那个银行卡去购物之后呢，我们的银行卡依然保持着完整又完美，
永无缺失。
So we want that kind of, we'd like to have that kind of sustainability that, you know, we're always complete.
我们希望就有这种持续性，能够永远是完整的。
And we see examples in the material world. You know, a woman conceives a child, she gives birth to a child. The child comes from her womb. the child is born, the woman is still complete. Even though she's produced a baby, it doesn't mean she's diminished in any way. She's still complete.
在物质世界呢，倘若一个妇女怀孕而生孩子，这个并不意味着生完孩子之后，这个妇女呢，她就不完整的。她生完孩子之后呢，这个妇女依然是完整的。
So in the same way, the Supreme Lord, in His form as Mahavishnu, so many universes are coming from Him.
至尊主以马哈维什诺形象，他躺在那里，有这么多的宇宙从他毛孔当中诞生出来。
Right, one breath of Mahavishnu, and all the universes are coming out from the pores of His body.
就是马哈维什诺，他的一呼就从他的身体产生出。无数的宇宙
but he still remains complete. He's still Mahavishnu.
但他依然是完整的 Mahavishnu.
Because that is the inconceivable nature of the Supreme Lord, that he is Purnam.
这就是至尊主的不可思议的本性，他是 Purnam.
So he's complete in every respect. He's not lacking in anything.
他在方方面面都是完整的，他从来不会有缺失。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna also says, "Aham sarvasya prabhavo mata sarvam pravartate." He said, "I am the source of the material and the spiritual worlds."
主在《不教万歌》第十章就说：“我是灵性世界和物质世界的根源。
”Everything emanates from me.
一切都发源于我。
So the wise who know this, they will worship the Lord with devotion.
智者会怀着奉爱来崇拜主。
So this is the chapter 10, verse number 8. This is Sambandha Gyan of the Chatur Shloki. This is the first verse of the Chatur Shloki, and this is Sambandha Gyan, knowledge of the relationship between the Lord and His energies.
在《薄伽梵歌》第十章的这四个种子世界当中。第八世界被称为是三班达第亚呢，描述的生物体和至尊主的关系。
So there's nothing lacking in the Supreme Lord in any way.
至尊主在任何方面，他都不会有任何的缺失缺憾。
In this way, he is complete.
他就是以这种方式被描述为是完整的。还有问题吗
？Yes,
Maria。我刚才说到一个比较棘手的问题，那个新来的人，他刚才我下楼下，他就很兴奋的跑来告诉我，他说：“哎呀，马大姐那个大你光刚才那庙长跟我说了，他说我可以脱臂，我跟我宝宝都要脱臂，他因为他是个很亲很亲的人。”他是我之前发展的一个朋友介绍过来，他对克算是就是等于是零基础这样的。我说我们有很系统培训，你想脱贫很好，但是你要对这灵性导师有所了解，而且你要遵守规范原则，要念诵十六圈。然后他一听我这么说，他就很激动情绪的。哦，好了，我现在决定了，我不脱贫。我说你可以，但是你要了解的是，我决定我以后都不脱贫了。啊，我要清理一下我的情绪，我要冷静一下。他就走开了。这种情况我怎么处理比较合适呢？
还有就是 ，Just now the temple president told her that she should take shelter for spiritual master, and then this
she asked if she could. The temple president, yes, you could.
啊，
他说是个庙长，
庙长。And then this Mataji with the daughter, and the Mataji is very excited, enthusiastic, and somewhat enthusiastically said that I shall take shelter. And then the Mataji told her that it's very nice, but you should first of all chant your 16 rounds and follow the principles.There's a procedure, and this Mataji, then she's somewhat agitated, and she said, "Then I'll never take shelter from the Guru." How shall I, may I ask, how shall I answer to Jordan?
Well, it's just obvious, you know, I'm just surprised that she's here on the program. Somebody who's not chanting 16 rounds and not familiar with the process, I don't know how they managed to get involved, to manage to take part in this gathering.
This
gathering is really meant for people who are already following Krishna consciousness, who are practicing seriously.
聚会奉献者聚会呢，是给那些已经遵守这个程序，非常认真的来修行的人来参加的。
So it's unfortunate that somebody comes along like that who's not very familiar with Krishna consciousness, and then these things happen. You know, they see somebody. Somebody tells them, you know, you have to take shelter, or why you're not initiated yet. And they think like that, and they have no knowledge. They have no, they never prepared themselves. They never practiced anything.
So, 就是这样的不幸的事情发生也是可以预料的，因为他们是一无所知，然后听到有人跟他们说，你应该脱壁。 你就应该告他应该怎么做，然后他们就在一无所知的情况下，他们就很草率的就做出决定，因为他们事先什么还没有做好任何准备呢。
Sometimes you know you get people coming, they still eat meat or they still smoke cigarettes or something, and they come along and they're with the devotees, and one minute they go off, they want to have a cigarette somewhere, or they want to go for a drink or something, you know. It's not very good.
也有那种情况，就是有的人他还抽烟喝酒，然后他就来到奉献的聚会当中待一会儿，然后又出去抽根烟喝点酒，然后他们就会有这种情况发生。
So people coming on this kind of gathering, you know, spending a lot of time here with the devotees and the temple and so on, they're expected to be familiar with our standards and to be able to keep these standards.
要来参加我们这个奉献者的聚会，因为我们是在庙宇当中进行的，有很多庙宇的活动，所以来参加这样活动的人呢，应该熟悉我们的标准，并且能够维持我们的遵守我们的标准。
So the lady said that she will never be able to take shelter. She could never come to that standard.
那如果这个新人他说出这种话，那么就意味着他就永远达不到，不能达到这个标准。
So then you have to say to her, "No, you can come to that standard if you practice. Now you're so fortunate that you're here with the devotees. You just have to keep that standard." Now you're here, you're following the standard here, so you have to keep the standard when you go back.
你就可以这样回答说，你特别幸运，你已经来到了这样的聚会上面，你可以在这里就保持这里的标准，之后等你回去之后呢，你要维持，继续维持这个标准。
But the point is, you know, really people coming to this kind of gathering, they should be already familiar with the devotees and familiar with the practice and the standards which we follow.
就我们期待的是，来参加这样活动的人呢，应该是已经熟悉奉献者，熟悉这个程序，并且熟悉这个标准。
Yes.
So, 敬拜工人敬拜翻译，我问一个问题，就是比如说心呢，我们培养到一定的程度，他要在家里给 Krishna 供奉食物，我们可以帮助他去建立家里的那个家庭神坛吗？或者是我们应该怎么做？还有 Krishna 答应过。
May I ask, can I help the new fighters to set up their altars so that they can offer food and to make an offering to the Lord in their own house?
Yes, why not?
可以，为什么不呢？
But pictures, only pictures. You're not going to put any actual deities there. Just put photographs.
就是只能让他们 在家里就神态上只能有照片，不能应该是立体神像。
You put the picture of Gornitai, Gornitai, they're very merciful.
你就给他们让在神态上设立了 Gornitai 的照片。
Chaitanya, Nityananda.They have come to deliver the fallen souls in the Kali Yuga.
主柴田鸟和尼天丹丹呢，是专为来拯救卡利年代的堕落灵魂的。
And then you put Srila Prabhupada's picture.
然后还可以设立，还要设立圣帕帕德的照片。
So they worship Prabhupada and Lord Chaitanya.
他们应该崇，他们就这样崇拜。Srila Prabhupada 和主柴丹雅。
They don't have to put any other guru's picture there yet.
他们不应该在神坛上安放，暂时不能安放其他 guru 的照片。
First, take shelter. Let them take shelter of Srila Prabhupada.
让他们首先托庇于 Srila Prabhupada。
And gradually they'll find out what is the qualification of a spiritual master.
逐渐的，他们就了解。一位灵性导师的资格。
And then they have to recognize who is their spiritual master.
之后呢，他们应该去找到，应该去理解谁是他自己的灵性导师。
But first thing to do is to take shelter of Srila Prabhupada.
但是首先首当其冲的是，他们应该托庇于 Srila Prabhupada。
So how to take shelter of Srila Prabhupada?
那问题就是他们该怎么去托庇舍勒帕帕帕呢？
They have to recite Srila Prabhupada's pranam mantra.
他们应该去能够背诵舍勒帕帕的顶拜祷文。
And they should read Srila Prabhupada's books.
他们还要阅读舍勒帕帕的书籍。
And they should hear about Srila Prabhupada.
他们应该去 hear lectures.
They can hear about Prabhupada's life.
Hear about.
他们要聆听。有关于舍勒帕帕的生平的事迹。
Just like we have the book Your Ever Well Wisher, we have many books about Prabhupada.
我们有永恒的祝福者，这样的有关舍勒帕帕生平的书籍。
So people coming into Krishna consciousness are encouraged to do like that. First of all, we come in and take shelter of Srila Prabhupada.
所以。来到 Krishna 知觉运动当中的人呢，就应该是首先托庇舍勒帕帕。
And gradually they'll learn and come to understand what is a spiritual master.
那第二件事呢，他们就应该去学习，并且明白灵性导师是他的地位是什么。
If a person doesn't know what is the qualification of a spiritual master.Then they won't be able to recognize who is a spiritual master.
谁要是还不能知道一位灵性导师真正领导的资格是什么的话，他就不能认出谁是一位真正灵性导师。
So first they have to learn these things.
所以他们首先应该学习。
So we have the ISKCON Disciple Course, which is very helpful for people to understand these things.
我们有 ISKCON 的门徒课程，是能帮助人们来学习的。
To learn how to identify, how to select a spiritual master.
去学习如何去选择一位灵性导师。
And learn also the process of initiation.
也学习起鱼的程序。
What is the procedure for initiation?
起鱼它的程序是如何的？
And they learn other things also. They learn like ISKCON, how is it managed?
他们也会学习到 ISKCON 国际 Krishna 智觉协会是如何管理的。
So it's important that they follow this kind of process. They go through these procedures.
所以很重要的一点就是他们应该走这个程序，应该学了解到这些程序是怎样的。
As early as possible, they should attend the disciple course.
他们越早学习门徒课程，对他们就越好。
And then they can take instruction from several people.
他们可以从好几个人那里呢接受教导训示。
We have many, we can have several Shiksha gurus, of course. The most prominent of our Shiksha guru will be Srila Prabhupada.
他们可以有好几位训示领导师，当然最重要的训示领导是Srila Prabhupada。
And from the Shiksha gurus, then one will become more prominent.
在他好几位训示领导师当中呢，其中就会有一位训示导师对他来说是非常重要的。
And then that person should become the Diksha guru.
那么这个人呢，就会成为他的启迪领导师。
So this is how Srila Prabhupada describes it in Chaitanya Charitamrita.
舍巴巴的在查丹纳查尔特米特就描述了这一切。
OK. Yes.
你看，顶班顾问马上要展开一下翻译。那我的问题是，我身边有新人啊，就是之前他吃素吃的挺好，但是在吃素的过程当中，家里人会强迫他去吃肉，他又反反复复，一直都这样反反复复，他就是断不了。像对这样的新人如何来带动Hare Krishna？
So there are new faddies around me. They are. For some period they are vegetarian, and then for some period they are forced by their family members to eat meat, and they will again and again become like this. So may I ask, how can I inspire this new devotee?
Well, very difficult when they're in that situation.That the family members are forcing them to eat meat. If they're not able to resist that force coming from the family members, then it will be very difficult to convince them about Krishna consciousness.
如果他们自己不能抵抗他们来自他们家庭成员的这个强迫力的话，他们要成为 Krishna 知觉就很困难。
I don't think they'll be very good candidates for devotional service.
Maharaj 说，那我不认为这样他们会成为奉献服务的很好的候选人。
They cannot maintain, they don't have the determination themselves to resist that kind of instruction, that kind of pressure coming from family members. Then it will be very hard.To convince them about Krishna consciousness.
如果他们自己就是没有这份决心来抗拒来自他们家庭成员的这个所谓的教诲，真正教诲或者来自家庭成员的这个压力的话，那么他们就很难自己有 Krishna 知觉，培养 Krishna 知觉。
Krishna 的在哭。我有个问题跟有个水马的提问有点相似，就是我们身边的一些新人的朋友，他们可能对我们这个哲学或者对分子的生活在更好奇，他想一探究竟。那么对这些人，我们如何能够维持他们跟绝对真理之间这种链接？我们应该做些什么？您能给我们一些建议和指导吗？哈利克什。
My question is that some people are very inquisitive about devotional life and the philosophy of Krishna consciousness. So may I ask, can you give some advice? So how should I deal with this kind of people to maintain, maybe to help them?
Well, you can give a book, give a, one some book, let them read a book.
你可以给他们书一本书，让他们去读书。
You have to consider what kind of book will be most suitable for them.
你就得仔细琢磨一下哪本书最适合他读。
Usually we think about Bhagavad Gita.Would be very good. Bhagavad Gita is like the ABC, it's the introduction to Krishna consciousness.
一般来说呢，我们认为《国家梵歌》是非常适合他们读的，因为《国家梵歌》就是 Krishna 直觉的基础课程 ABC.
But it's not very easy for a lay person to read that book, Bhagavad Gita, especially Chinese edition.All the Indian names put into Chinese makes it very difficult for people to read.
但是对于一个世俗的人呢，去读《国家梵歌》呢，就挺难的。特别是中文版的《国家梵歌》，有很多梵文的人名儿，所以他们就读就很难来理解。
So I think.Better to let them read the small books. We have small books which are based on Prabhupada's lectures.
所以最好就让他们读那些小书，这些小书呢都是根据时的 Prabhupada 的讲课来编辑整理出来的。
Books like Beyond Birth and Death.
超越生死。
Perfection of Yoga.
瑜伽的完美境界。
On the Way to Krishna.
通向 Krishna 的道路。
These are all taken from Prabhupada's lectures. They're all edited lectures put into text.
这些都是出自释迦牟尼佛的讲课，被编辑成这个文字书籍。
So I think those are good books. To maybe, but maybe you like to have something more scholarly. You have to consider what is the nature of the person you're trying to approach.
你还得考虑，就是这个人他的本性是什么？是不是他们就有点学者风范的这样的本性
？Some people may even be familiar with the Bhagavad Gita. So if they're familiar with the Bhagavad Gita, then it's a bit easier.
如果有的人呢，他已经听说了《国家梵歌》，熟悉《国家梵歌》，那就容易了。
So you have to. It's not.The same for everyone. Some people like to read stories. Therefore, I say you can read about Prabhupada's life.
不是那是因人而异的。比如有的人喜欢读书，喜欢读故事，那么就是帕帕德的生平，这样传记就很适合这样的人。
You have to pray to Krishna.When you give somebody the book, you have to pray that, to guide you, to let you know what's the best thing to give them.
就当你要给别人一本书的时候，你要向 Krishna 祈祷，祈求 Krishna 指引你来给他一个什么样最适合他读的书。
Sometimes it's good to let them, you know, they could come and listen to the lectures which are given on the internet.
有的时候呢，让他们来听网络的课程，对他们也是有好处的。
What's the Vaikuntha Ji? You can some things there, some of these lectures.
就是我们早课，白坤的之前的早课。
Sometimes people like to hear, just listen to kirtan. If they just hear kirtan, they hear a lot of kirtan, they can get a lot of purification. Just hearing the kirtan.
有的人呢喜欢 kirtan, 你就让他们听大量的 kirtan, 这样他们就能得到净化。
And of course, prasadam is always very powerful.
而且 prasadam 是总是永远都是最有力量。
You make something.Very nice, tasty, but then you have to consider what kind of, you know, not everybody likes sweet things.
You can 自己做非常美味的可口的不沙的，但是还得注意，有的人不喜欢吃甜食。
Prabhupada would sometimes give people big gulab jamuns, you know, big balls of sugar and syrup.
这个方法有时候让人们来吃那个叫伊斯康子弹，在糖浆里的做的甜球。
你吃过吗？So you know, sometimes if you give that to some people, they go, you know, they won't like it. Not, it's not everyone's taste.
有的人一看这个就发怵，太感觉这他们太甜了，受不了。
Samosa's a bit better, and if you can make a nice samosa.
如果你会做特别好吃的 samosa 就相对来说比较适合吃。
不知道 samosa 是什么。Samosa, yeah, it's like a java, but it's fried pastry.
就是薯炸薯角。炸薯角里面是蔬菜，然后是炸的。
And they use cauliflower for a potato for the filling.
那里头的馅儿呢，是用菜花，然后土豆。
And they will have a sauce with it as well. They serve a sauce with it.
他们还有这个酱，蘸酱。
If you go to India, you go to our temple, for example, in Juhu.If you go to the ISKCON temple in Mumbai, there's a temple at Juhu. The first temple in Mumbai was at Juhu. So they make samosas there, and there's always a big line of people. They all line up to buy the samosa.
我们在ISKCON 在孟买的第一所庙朱湖庙，他们做的那个 samosa， 就人们会长排很长的队来领这个炸薯角。
It's very famous.
这个 samosa 在朱富庙非常有名儿。
Everybody in Mumbai, they all know. Oh yes, samosa is very good.
孟买人都说，哦 ，samosa 特别好吃。
So they're different things, you know. You have to think.
学学学，回爸妈也。
这个
妈也会做，
她会做啊！
过节我她都做。
这个妈也可以教你。Prabhupada went to America, he took some books, the first canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam with him, and he would go to the bookstores to sell the books, and he would make samosas, and he would always give samosas to the people in the bookstore.
圣帕巴德在印度的时候，他派国家瓦坛，他会到那书店派国家圣美国家瓦坛的时候，他就带上了那个。
在美国。
在美国。
不是在印度，在美国。
啊、他在美国，圣帕巴德在美国派圣美国家瓦坛的时候，他去书店，他就会带着 samosa， 就也一起给人们吃。
Prabhupada attracted the devotees with prasadam. It was the biggest thing, you know, in preaching to people, to get people interested in Krishna consciousness. He cooked the best prasadam.
要想把人们吸引到 Krishna 知识当中，要做出最上乘、最一流、最本位的 prasadam. 释迦牟尼佛早期的时候，就是通过有的人通过 prasadam 被吸引来的。
We're often known as the kitchen religion.
我们 的宗教而闻名。
Because we do spend a lot of time cooking for Krishna.
因为我们会花大量的时间为 Krishna 来烹饪。
And then we distribute the prasada for everyone.
然后我们给每个人派prasada。
If you go to Australia, in Australia, everyone knows Hare Krishna because of their prasada.
如果你去澳大利亚，澳大利亚每个人都因为是prasada来了解了有 Hare Krishna。
And the devotees make things that they're very, their kofta balls are very famous.
Kofta.
Kofta. With tomatoes, your tomato sauce.
洋白菜切碎，然后过成泥炸，然后西红柿酱。
那个拉什米会做不少，会做这个。
他会吃。
会做还会吃。
But the devotees in Australia, they go like they have music festivals, you know, rock concerts and things like that. And the devotees will go and they'll cook kofta balls and they sell plates of it, and people just go crazy. They love it. They line up. They all buy it.
就在澳大利亚有那个举行摇滚音乐会的时候呢，奉献者就趁着机会做很多的烤麸球，还有这个西红柿酱，然后他们就会打包就卖，然后人们就特别特别喜欢吃，然后他们就吃了都陶醉了。
Kofta, kofta, yes, my lady.
它是炸的，
哦，那个没电了。
Hare Krishna, Pranamakumar Maharaj, 很高翻译，很高爱所有的奉献者。我这边有一个曼加尔的学员，他刚好问到这样的问题，我想请姑姑来解答就最好不过了。他是一个妈妈级，然后呢，他的小孩大概七八岁，他自己的生活面临很大的一个挑战，就是孩子会经常的心口疼，疼的有的时候就要去医院，然后根本没法睡觉，包括在他们目前的居住的环境里边。也是没法睡着的，所以他们在我们这次来之前有曾经几天就是夫妇两个人拎着箱子在大街上到处找房子，因为暑期的这个酒店是非常紧张的。同时他的帕布呢也是一个脾气非常不好的人，他很害怕他的帕布回来会任何时间就会发脾气。那因为他经常有的时候会带孩子去联谊，然后孩子回去也会说一些窥视他的语言，所以又因为孩子这个状况，所以这个妈大吉的家里人就很不同意他来修行。他的爸爸甚至就是已经禁止他带孩子来去联谊了。但是他的小孩很小，如果他不带孩子，他自己本人也是没法来联谊的。他目前还很坚定的在修行，包括念诵十六圈，还没有脱壁。所以他的生活面临很大的挑战，虽然他很乐观，所以他的问题是：我如何能够去臣服？如何能够在这样痛苦的情况之下？维持一个坚定的信心，还有就是，
There's a Manjari student. The Mataji had a small child, and the father, because the child had a disease, that the chest would become very painful.The chest, they will sometimes it's
in and out of hospital, 不能睡觉
cannot sleepless. And the father is very against the mother to take the child to a devotee association. But the mother is very determined, and still she's chanting 16 rounds.So under the difficult situation, so may I ask how can Can she continue to practice Krishna consciousness in this difficult situation? Yeah, how can she become more surrendered?
Well, again, she's bringing her problems into the Krishna conscious society.
所以就是跟刚才那个一样，就是他把他的问题带到了 Krishna 这个协会当中了。
And it's definitely it's very dangerous for our society if her husband gets upset about this. He can give a lot of trouble for all of our devotees.
这对我们协会来说呢，也是一个危险。如果她的丈夫呢为此而生气，对不对？
其实她丈夫没有，是她的父亲。她的丈夫是一个脾气很不好的人，经常会发脾气。
The husband is not against, but is hot-tempered. The problem is the mother's father is against, very against.
That's right. It just takes one person to be against, and they can give you a lot of trouble.
只要有一个人反对，就会给协会带来很大的麻烦。
They go to the police. And the police come, and a lot of problem for everybody.
一旦他父亲要是报警，然后警察来了，接下来就会有问题，大家都不安宁。
It's a common thing. We our movement in America, we suffered a lot for these kind of things.
这个事件也是普遍的。我们在美国的时候呢，我们就因为这样的事件呢，就受牵连了。
Some young girl runs away from home, wants to be a devotee.
有些年轻女孩就离家出走，想要当奉献者。
And the devotees give her shelter in the temple.
庙宇的奉献者呢，就让她在庙宇当中留宿。
And then eventually the parents find out where the girl is.
最后父母终于发现，就是他们的女儿在哪，他们下落。
And they put legal cases against our society.
他们就起诉我们的协会。
We have to pay a lot of money.
我们还得给他们补偿金。
So you have to consider for one person, you're going to take a lot of risk. It's not worth it.
所以你要考虑到这一点，就为了一个人冒这么大的风险，是不是值得？
They have to work out their own problems.
他们的这个问题啊，他们还得自己去解决。
They can't expect that we can help them and give them all the support. It just makes it very dangerous for a very big problem for us.
他们不能指望着我们来解决他们问题，这对我们来说是非常危险的，来处理他们这个棘手问题。如果他们就让我们来支持他们来解决他们这个问题。
Everywhere we get these kind of things. I just got a message yesterday. Somebody is telling me about this man wants to leave home.
昨天的马拉只收到一条短信，说有一个男子想离开家。
The family are against him practicing Krishna consciousness.
他的家人反对他修习 Krishna 之觉。
They don't want him offering any food at home.
他们不让他在家里供奉食物。
And he got his books, and he gave his books to the police. They got his Krishna conscious books.
他们就拿了他的这个男子的 Krishna 之觉的书，交给了警方。
And then the police come and they say, "Where's the man? We want to meet the man. Tell the man to come to the police station. We want to talk to him."
然后这个警察就来找，说这个男子在哪儿。我们想让他去警察局跟他谈一谈。
He doesn't want to go.
然后这个男子不想去警察局。
OK. Because, you know, if he goes there, you know, they're going to ask a lot of questions. So, you know, family problems, it's not our concern. We don't want to get involved with individual family problems.
他的家庭问题呢，不是我们的问题，我们不想卷入到他的家庭问题当中。
其实他的这个问题并不是说要我们来帮他解决孩子的问题或者先生的问题，就是我们在人生中总会碰到各种各样的困难。他的问题是我如何在困难中不断的维持信心，他指的是这些，并不是具体的。
The mother is not, it is not asking us to help her to solve the problem. The mother is asking how can she strengthen her faith in spite of all the difficulties.
我觉得我那孩子小的时候也是这样病。其实这个就是他家吧。念诵自己别断了，就带孩子看病啊，是吧？家庭的职责还照样，对，该怎么做就是暗地里还是加上我们的这个规范就 OK 了，慢慢的也就会过去了。因为我那也是很多年孩子病得很厉害，吐啊头疼都几乎上不了学嘛，后来就可是我就没有停下我的修行，对，他自己坚持啊，完了该看病该家人他也得，因为他也着急嘛，他丈夫是吧，睡不了觉，谁脾气也好不了，他怎么会疼啊？医生怎么说？
看不出任何毛病，你看他每次都没什么生理上的问题，反正他一紧张孩子就去。
自己家里问题就得自己解决，度过难关。
我想请教古玛哈拉姐，就是在咱们做早上贴的时候，做完就是要拜过主。还有你信函以后该绕图拉西绕三圈，就是发现原来我是绕有全身嘛，接着还有那个使徒传戏，每个人绕三圈，就是说绕全身。后来有一个资深奉献者在讲课的时候说绕半身，这个我不知道重要不重要，就是想确认一下，应该绕全身还是绕半身？
供奉完图拉西之后是吧？
就是供完你信函之后，从图拉西那边不开绕三圈吗？绕三圈，
叫
RT 不都每个人绕三圈吗？这个三圈，原来他们说的绕全身，后来有个资深奉献人讲课的时候绕半身，我就不知道绕全身还是半身。
My question is that, during the Mangala RT, we offer the Gilan Prasadam to Tulsi Devi and Guru Parampara.Some devotees said that only certain ambient the Gilan half
full body, like arti to full complete figure or just half. She wondered that's a matter or not, it's important or not to do the full body offering or half body offering to the Parampara.
Is it important?
I took DT worship course for 3 times from the two Prabhus. As far as I learned, should be like half body because it's considered Mahaprasadam and we are offering Mahaprasadam. Because she's asking after Lord Sinadev, like, then we offer to Tulsi and the Parampara. What do you think, Guru Maharaj?
I never heard this before. I never took the deity worship course in
1992.
I don't think it's too important.
前天讲的国家瓦坛找客就提到人分两类，这个我在巴格瓦吉塔4:15节也看见，药子帕帕开篇就提到说人分两类，一类人心中充满了物质欲望，那么另一类人是没有物质欲望，就超然于物质欲望之外的。那么慧士纳自觉对两者都有好处。第一个，遵循奉献服务的规范原则，就能逐渐净化自己。那后面没有物质欲望的，也没有杂念，可以继续在慧士纳自觉中活动，以自身的榜样教育他人。我想知道，我们还有教导说我们都有六项不洁。那这六项不洁都是从物质欲望发端出来的，那么色欲产生愤怒，产生贪婪，骄傲、嫉妒、虚幻，那么它可以这六项是不都可以就是归到一个物质欲望的源头呢？那么所有人都有物质欲望，那么从粗糙的或者是精微的，就是能看见的。钱呢，财富啊，衣服啊，还有看不见的我们心意当中的，就比如这六项不洁。那么一个是帕帕说的这个后面一种人没有物质欲望的，他这个物质欲望的概念是通通没有呢，还是说没有粗糙的物质欲望？这是第一个问题。
你可以变好
要重说吗？
我觉得你应该总结一下这个，
我想你摘要出来。
问题是，
我的初衷是，我们想，咕噜讲到，我们想要纯粹的为 Krishna 做奉爱服务，那么就要断绝一切物质的欲望，我们的真正的奉爱服务才开始。那我们知道那六项不洁，我们就能觉察到的是愤怒，然后骄傲、嫉妒，然后虚幻，一会儿就迷糊了，这些我们都能觉察到的。那么是不是100%都没有的时候是要主动的，我又说多了哈，主动的去弃绝呢？还是说在规范休息当中慢慢的专注于规范休息，慢慢的就被净化了。这个物质欲望是要主动的放手，像毛一样，那个船的毛一样，你要自己拔出来，还是说逐渐就被净化了？又说复杂了，必须请大家原谅。
我去总结一下，
帮
一下，
来来
来。Our main questions, we have 6 impurities. Shall we get rid of the one?Each one by one, or we just perform a devotional service and then
you just perform devotional service.
你只要奉献服务就行
了。慢慢就好。
不知不觉的净化。
不知不觉的净化。
就是说有四种人来到慧士纳自觉当中。前三种是充满了物质欲望，后面一种追求真理的是没有物质欲望的。那这里面这个追求真理的是不是这个汉汉说的第二类人呢？就是那咕噜们，我知道咕噜们是就是汉汉的年代是从西皮士很多是通过很多进化然后达到现在纯粹的一个，还是说生来就有这么一种人，他已经觉悟自我了，然后来到慧士纳自觉当中，然后他是帕帕说的第二种人，是要不需要进化就本身。
There are altogether 4 kinds of people that come into Krishna.
Arta, Artarti, Jigyasu, and Gyani, and the last one is the best. So a Gyani is considered to be already purified person or still have some material desires. It's like already self-realized person.
He still has some material desires because he's desiring that knowledge.
就第四种人Gyani，他们还是有物质欲望，因为他们物质欲望是他们想要知识。
So these people, they make progress very slowly.
这类人呢，他们的进步呢很缓慢。
Right. After many births and deaths, then finally they understand Vasudev Sarvamiti, that Vasudev is everything.
经过生生世世世世之后呢，他们最终就明白到 Vasudev Sarvamiti， Vasudev 就是一切。
不如说这个在韦达传统里面比较好理解，但是在我们中国的修行当中，就咱们说追求生命的意义，可以说是这第四类人吗？追求生命的真相的是可以这么解释吗
？My question is those people who are seeking the absolute truth, the truth of life, can they be categorized as this kind of the Gyani?
Well, it's not pure devotion.
他们不是他们这种呢，也不是纯粹的奉爱。
Dhyana misubhata.
Dhyana 他们是混杂着 Dhyana 的，混杂着知识的，奉献者 Dhyana misubhata.
就是他也要走
混杂着知识的奉爱，
就是也要。按照规范修习最终达到进化都是帕帕树的第一类人
需要时间通过时间慢慢的进步
你不必那么在意他是第几类人
就是我就是想知道我们还有那么多的那个不解这一点没有了我们才能开始做纯粹奉献服务是不是我们的奉爱服务还没有开始
We now doing devotion service because we are still have a material desire and we are not still pure.
Well, not for everyone. Some people are pure. You may have material desires. It doesn't mean everyone has material desire.
就是这并不意味着就是说您有物质欲望，然后别人就也有物质欲望。有的人他是纯洁的。
Some people come just out of pure devotion. They don't have that desire to cultivate the knowledge like what you may have.
有的人来就是为了做纯粹的奉爱服务的，可能不像您那样是想来从中获得知识的，有这种动机。
So Dhruva Maharaj was only a little boy, and he saw God. The Lord came in 6 months. After 6 months, he achieved perfection.
Dhruva Maharaj, he was just a little boy. He reached perfection in 6 months. Now he is the Lord.
So it's possible people can make progress very quickly. It doesn't take any time at all. They just have simply devotion for Krishna. They just have that attraction, that love for Krishna. They want to love Krishna.
所以有的人是可以很快的能达到奉爱的层面的，有的人呢，他就是仅仅是为了奉爱，专门是为了奉爱而来的。
And they just fall in love with chanting the holy name. They're constantly chanting.
有的人呢，他一进来他就喜欢唱诵，他就一进来呢被圣名就吸引了，就喜欢圣名。
So it's not that everybody has to take.You know, long time to come to that point of devotion.
So, 并不是每个人都需要很长的时间才能达到奉爱这一层面。
Some people, you see, some people in their previous lives have already been devotees, but they didn't complete the process, and so they're coming again, and they're continuing from where they left off.
有些人上一世就是奉献者了，但是没有完成，所以他们这一世呢，他们就继续做奉爱服务。
Some people, they just take to Krishna consciousness so quickly, so natural for them.
有些人呢，他们接受 Krishna 之觉呢，特别自然而然的，就很快就接受了。
And other people, we have so many doubts in this, and we're thinking so many things. We have so many thoughts about what's right and what's not.
有的人脑子里就很多的疑惑，很多的想法，有很多的思辨，哪个是对的，哪个是错的呀？
So we see some people, some people like they're born in a good family, maybe they're born in the holy land, maybe they take birth in Braja, or they're born in a devotee family.
有的人呢，他就直接都投生在 Braja 的家门，有的呢就投生在奉献者的家庭。
Very quickly they make progress in Krishna consciousness.
他们在 Krishna 知觉当中呢取得飞速的进步。
Because they already had.From their previous births, they already had made progress.
他们前世呢就已经取得了进步了。
So it's not that it has to be so long. It has to be like that for everyone. That it takes a long time to become a devotee, to do devotional service.
所以并不是说每一个人就是做需要花很长的时间才能开始做奉爱服务或成为奉献者。
Bhagavad Gita says in the 18th chapter, Brahma Bhuta Prasanatma, right? You have to come to the platform Brahma Bhuta. We have to know ourselves as spirit souls.
主在薄伽梵歌第十八章说，要达到 Brahma Bhuta Prasanatma， 我们要知道自己是灵魂，灵性灵魂。
And then Samasarveshu Bhuteshu, we see all living entities equally.
还要看到平等，以平等的视野看待众生。
Brahma Bhuta, nasochati na kanchati. They don't hanker and lament for anything.
达到梵的层面的人，他们既不渴求，也不悲伤，也不哀伤。
Material life is all hankering and lamenting.
物质生活呢，要么就是渴求，要么就是在那里哀叹。
We're thinking hankering. We're thinking about the future, what we want to get.
我们的渴求就是我们就计划着未来我们想要得到什么。
And we lament about the past.
然后另一方面呢，我们也为过去而在那里哀叹着。
But devotional service, you have to leave that behind. You have to give up that hankering and lamenting.
但是在做奉献服务的过程当中呢，要把这个渴求和哀伤，把这两种情绪都要放掉。
Coming to Brahma Bhuta platform, then devotional service begins.
当自己达到 Brahma Bhuta 这个层面上之后，在这个层面上之上，然后就可以开始做奉爱了。
So it doesn't have to take a long time.
这并不一定要花很长时间。
But you have to conquer the mind.
但你首先要征服心意。
说划船，划了一夜的船，然后那个
对
大家一出来发现还在原地，毛没有拔出来。然后我们的那个毛，就是我们要通过努力主动的去发现这个毛，然后拔出来这个毛。是这样。
是这样。
顶麦咕噜，顶麦翻译，顶麦所有的观众们，我的问题是，我是来自福建，就是宁德地区福地的一个小城市，我的问题是， 因为我这四年当中我都没有出来联谊过，就是我倒是跟佛教徒联谊，然后呢我们那里也是非常虔诚的佛教徒，但是我们那里有万善联盟，有一个大善人，但是都是年轻人主持的，我呢是其中的一位啊，包括素食啊，因为我最近在那个爱的味道里面有写到了现场，每个星期我们都会去现学现用，然后呢我们每个星期有一次的派发素食的大餐，其中有几个发起人，因为我们都是年轻人，我是属于是比他们年纪大了，就是其他人都是四十多岁而已，他们学习的能力都很强，只是学《论语》啊、中国的《道德经》啊这一块，这些基础品质都非常好的。其中有几位是真诚的、追求真理的这些人，学习非常强的。他只是问我：“叶姐，为什么你的素食比别人的素食好吃呢？”然后还有一个。就是我告诉他我是写凤爱瑜伽的，凤爱瑜伽是全球的，他说为什么我们宁德清溪只有你一个人呢，如果多了我就跟你学，因为他们都是比较受欢迎的，所有的和尚啊这些高僧大德啊都会去，觉得这些人都是很真诚的，我们这一群人都非常好的，所以很多师父们都喜欢来我们这个混为，然后我只是告诉他我现在没有能力去跟你们讲的太多，如果讲太多了反而对你们来说是一种怀疑，我只是保持一种真诚，而这种呢就是一个真诚，一个做一个好人而已吧，接下来可能是有可能会奇迹会发生，就是我怎么能跟他们回答更好的一种语言表达能力呢，还有一个就是发起人，一个就是最主要的，他只是说叶姐你这样真诚，我们可以给你塑造一个你的平台，属于你自己的那种真诚的这个真修的一个氛围，所以我这次在百忙当中我就出来联谊了，就跟大家混着联谊，我回去应该怎么样去做的稍微有进步一点点吧，谢谢。
Well, two things are very important. 两个事情都特别重要 ，Kirtan 还有 Prasada。
有两件特别重要的，一是 Kirtan， 还有 Prasada。
You need to have more Kirtan. If they have a lot of Kirtan, then they can get some real progress.
所以你需要做很多很多的 Kirtan， 这样他们就能取得真正的进步。
Sometimes people say they're interested. You have to see. You know, the more you have kirtan, you have to see how long they're willing to stay and chant, and how much they're willing to actually hear about Krishna.
有的人说他们感兴趣，但是你得测试，你得看，当你做 kirtan 的时候呢，他们能在 kirtan 当中待多久，在那里聆听。
Okay, prasadam, they can appreciate your prasadam, yeah, very nice. That, but it takes a long time to make devotees just by prasadam.
Her daughter sing kirtan very beautiful. Her daughter.
So, we need to get them to sing.
Yeah. 然后
拉
着说他女儿会 kirtan
唱得很棒，
妈妈说我得让他们来唱，
你女儿带他们唱。
我俩最近在闲招都没回去。
I think so. Okay. Yeah, I'm going for prasadam.
Okay.
1:30 or something.
下次再优先
明天
两次，明天。
OK， 我们的事情到了。
是我们
不要。Two Mataji and
question.
Still tomorrow.
You see,
how many devotees have more questions? One, two, more questions?
谁还有问题的可以举手。
One. Okay, tell her not to miss the next question and answer session.
那你可，那你不是，他们说你下回千万不要错过下回的机会。
God bless. Hare Krishna.
She said she has
to go back.
Nityananda.
Nityananda.
Go back.
Go back.
Nityananda.
Nityananda.
Gauranga.
Because you see, Prasadam is waiting for us. Prasadam is Lord Krishna himself. We should not keep waiting.
Prasadam is Krishna 本人，我不能让 Krishna 等我们。
So, wait.
So,
Today is a special menu. It's cooked by the temple president. It's basically Pasindu Prabhu. He makes also a Chinese soup for you. And some kind of dish like sweet and sour. And coke.
有点甜，有点酸。
Mixed vegetables, also he make mixed vegetables.
他还做那个，就是把各种蔬菜，十几蔬菜。
And rice, he make a lot of things. It's a feast today.
做了很多，给大家做了大餐，大米饭。
Remember that today, after the prasadam, we got.The boat is going back to the hotel, the villa, go back to the villa, you take a rest, and then by 6 p.m. you must be back in the bus.
那大家记住，就是和善完之后呢，回那个宾馆或者是回别墅休息几个小时，然后六点钟是要坐车到。
We coming back to the temple for the.
有个事儿就是，祭司让六点到这个庙堂，完了。一块儿给我那个孩儿他爸爸做一个祭祀。
Because at 6 o'clock we're going to do a special prayers in the altar for Sandini Mataji's
heart. We're
going to tell you also the mantras, maybe we can share in the WeChat group.So you all have the mantras to chant. We're going to chant the name of Narasimha Deva and different mantras. And then we're going to do bhajans and kirtan today.
Did you make the song book?
Did you get the song book?
We have a digital.
So we have bhajans and kirtan and Krishna Katha. Hare Krishna.
One question, Maharaji Prabhu. Online devotees, they want to know what is time for evening class?
7:30.
7
o'clock is Sunday Arctic, and Sunday Arctic the finish at 7:30.
7:00 is 黄昏灯仪, 7:30 is 晚课.
Remember the hotel has a swimming pool. The hotel.
在那个我们的宾馆呢，它是有游泳池的。
I see some they go to the swimming pool, but not many.
有一些去的，不是很多，
没有很多人去。
有的人知道有游泳池就去了，有的人还不知道。
How many Matajis and Prabhu? How many They know how to swim. How many?
都要会游泳的就举手。我会，没带游泳衣啊。
You see, okay, today, 4 o'clock, 4 p.m. can go to the swimming pool.
今天下午4点就可以去。
Take the children.
可以带着孩子去游泳。
If you don't know how to swim, no problem, because the water is here.
不会游泳没关系，它有那个潜水区域。
You can learn.
还可以趁机就在那学习。
You go. And then they have an hour, they go back, get ready, 5:30 in the bus, okay?
可以在那游半个小时，然后5:30准时上车。
Hare Krishna, Prasadam.
十八分。